In space, no one can hear you complain about that leaky faucet. Also, you definitely can't call a plumber, so how do things get fixed? Hey Tinkerers, Trace here for DNews. Space is only 62 miles away, but it's taken countless hours of engineering and science throughout history to get us there. But there's one thing that all machines will do, and that is fail. They will eventually and inevitably fail. A mechanical failure is always an annoyance, but when it happens in space, that is all compounded, and even little things can become huge challenges. If anything goes wrong, astronauts are on their own, and as astronaut Don Pettit told DNews, mission control can think of 80% of things, but even they can't cover all of it. And when that happens, according to Pettit, you need to become MacGyver. Love that show. As the ISS is pretty much like going into the wilderness in the most awesome science future way possible, astronauts need to be self-sufficient and creative thinkers, which is part of the reason they go through years of rigorous training in medical, engineering, flight, and so on. So when things do break, how do they repair them? Unconventionally. In 2006, astronauts on the ISS were testing experimental heat shield gel by spreading it on test surfaces, but they needed to smooth it out. Doing that in space wearing an EVA suit, that proved difficult, so they used spatulas from their kitchen. Yep, just regular old spatulas. On January 15, 2003, Don Pettit and Ken Bowersox suited up for another EVA to clean debris off the outside of the docking port so they could safely attach a service module and move cargo into the station. The problem was sandblasting that had been going on down on the launch pad in the days before the shuttle had launched had contaminated the cargo with sand. The shuttle brought sand with it to space. Somehow, the sand got caught in the lubricant on the outer hatch, which would have compromised docking. I interviewed astronaut Don Pettit, and he said that he used wire, not unlike a coat hanger, and a t-shirt to wipe the sand off so that they could get a better seal. This is a true story. Another major repair device used in space, duct tape. They used it on Skylab to help astronauts' boots lock into the floor. They also use a specialized Klaxon tape, sort of like a reflective electrical tape. During Gemini Titan 4, astronaut Ed White performed the first EVA, or spacewalk, ever, and he wrapped his two tethers in Klaxon tape to keep them neat and untangled. Obviously, these are just a few minor examples, but being a MacGyver is definitely part of the astronaut mentality. As Pettit put it, we've got the best experts on the ground, and spaceflight is the ultimate team sport. Astronauts go through intensive training. They're members of NASA's astronaut corps, and the requirements are superior academic qualifications, but also a certain temperament. According to a NASA representative, astronauts need to be cool in risky and isolated environments. They're likely to be gregarious and someone who would be considered a good neighbor. But Pettit told me, you need to be a tinkerer too, because quote, if you tinker on Earth, you're going to be good at tinkering on orbit. Astronauts are the kind of people that when something breaks, they figure out how it works and then how to fix it in microgravity with whatever they have around. Since NASA ended the space shuttle program in 2011, the International Space Station is even more out on a limb. Without the large shuttle to bring replacement boxes, as Pettit called them, they're forced to repair things that were never meant to be repaired in space, like when Pettit fixed the onboard refrigerator during one of his missions. The ISS is slated to fly until 2024, another 8 years, and things are aging. They're testing 3D printing technology on orbit to make some parts, but there will always be someone MacGyvering and jury-rigging to survive in the final frontier. If you're thinking, why bother? Leave it be. We don't need the ISS. Let me try and convince you with this video about why the ISS even matters at all. The ISS has hosted more than 200 people who've completed over 180 spacewalks and 278 research projects comprising 1,000 experiments, each one teaching us about our planet, the life on it, how it all fits together, how our organisms surviving in space, and how they survive here on Earth. One time, I lowered a lead weight with sticky tape onto a fishing line into a space between the drywall and outer wall 15 feet to recover a USB adapter. It was so awesome. I was like a true MacGyver that day. Do you have a MacGyver story? Let us know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews. Thanks for watching.